one side that that's bad and they're going to spread the virus while the other one sort of gets a pass. The virus doesn't discriminate based on political viewpoint, and neither do I, and I don't think we should in general, with the giant caveat that please be careful out there. But
I should note on the Stacey Abrams comparison, I mean, the reason that she was effective post her race was because she actually started, you know, a nonprofit to get out the vote, to really juice up the voter turnout to make sure people have the right to exercise their right.
But do we think if Trump did not concede, which would be, I think we can all agree, wrong, that if he started an effective GOTV nonprofit, that we would all be giving him magazine covers and good coverage? No, I don't think that would be right. And yet it happens on the other side, and I think he sees that very clearly.
I just don't think that there's a total comparison there. But let's move on, because I don't want to make this, you know, President Trump versus Stacey Abrams. Go ahead, Ryan. Did you want to say something?
I take that point. Look, and, you know, I don't want to be too cute about this, but, you know, Donald Trump is no Stacey Abrams. It was a more defensible post-election non-concession, I guess I would call it, in terms of
what... I mean, the margin was larger.
Yeah, but let's, you know, I think it's fair to point it out, but I do want to call a little false equivalence on, like, what Trump is doing in trying to delegitimize the incoming president, not honoring him with the traditional smooth transition. It's a little bit, it is a little bit different.
Oh, wow. All right. Well, Mary Catherine, going from slopper to proper right there. Anybody who's followed her for a long time knows that she used to be a pretty right-leaning voice over at CNN, a voice of reason, and then suddenly started sounding exactly like everybody else on CNN. Rather than speculate on why that is, why don't we focus on the hilariously predictable response from that propagandist pretending to be a news lady and her cohort there, who trots out the typical rationalization response that, oh, it's different when we do it for nebulous reasons that are transparently partisan and nonsensical. But before we get to that, I do want to quickly thank this channel's very generous and very supportive sponsor, Noble Gold. If you're anything like me, you're wondering what's going on with these markets. Right now, they're all over the place and nobody knows what's happening. Will they grow or come crashing down? One thing's for sure, gold has kept people safe for thousands of years through war, national disaster, and financial troubles. That's why Noble Gold is inviting you to get safe with gold this time. They're gifting a solid 24-karat American Gold Eagle coin and a spectacular display case with every qualifying IRA or 401k, started before the end of November. Gold has been looking after people for thousands of years, and this time is no different. It's the only proven way of keeping hold of the value of your retirement fund, no matter what happens out there. No call centers, no sales pitch, straight through to the experts who will give you your options. So go to www.noblegoldinvestments.com and get this special coin offer. Or you can call 877-646-5347. Go to www.noblegoldinvestments.com. Again, that's www.noblegoldinvestments.com.
I should note on the Stacey Abrams comparison, I mean, the reason that she was effective post her race was because she actually started, you know, a nonprofit to get out the vote, to really juice up the voter turnout to make sure people have the right to exercise their right.
But do we think if Trump did not concede, which would be, I think we can all agree, wrong, that if he started an effective GOTV nonprofit, that we would all be giving him magazine covers and good coverage? No, I don't think that would be right. And yet it happens on the other side, and I think he sees that very clearly.
I just don't think that there's a total comparison there, but let's move on.
Oh my God. I mean, I just love how indignant and arrogant this hack is in response to what is obviously true, that the media applies different medical standards to mass gatherings depending on if they're pushing a left-wing Democrat Party agenda. Remember all those medical professionals that were insisting that these protests were important enough to offset the danger of being a super spreader event? This is one of the main reasons that people out there are so skeptical of claims made about the coronavirus from the media and the so-called professionals, which is another reason that our fake press has become a danger to the public. I mean, if anybody is sowing distrust in our institutions, it's them. But in any case, her attempt to rationalize why it's different when Democrats do it is something that's very typical, and it's something that I've been pointing out on this channel for many years now. Okay, so this is the part where this third string left-wing CNN hack runs to her leftist media cohort from Politico to save her.
Because I don't want to make this, you know, President Trump versus Stacey Abrams. Go ahead, Ryan. Did you want to say something?
I take that point. Look, I've covered the Trump White House now for 4 years. I interviewed Stacey Abrams the other day right before the election. And, you know, I don't want to be too cute about this, but, you know, Donald Trump is no Stacey Abrams.
Okay. I guess thanks for admitting that you prefer Democrats and that's why you think it's different when she refuses to concede an election. It's just funny to me how completely oblivious to the fact that he's admitting that he's a partisan hack.
It was a more defensible post-election non-concession, I guess I would call it, in terms of
I mean, the margin was much larger.
Yeah, but let's, you know, I think it's...
My God, she nearly knocked him senseless there. He almost sounds like he's having a stroke. As he's hackishly trying to explain why it's different when Democrats do it, Mary Catherine correctly points out that the margin that Abrams had lost was much larger. Despite that, the media rallied around her, championing her as a hero, despite the fact she would not concede the election. I don't think she ever conceded. This New York Times article about her not conceding on April 28th, 2019, paints her as a hero, saying, quote, despite being the first black female nominee from a major party to run for governor of any state, Georgia's Stacey Abrams surely couldn't have anticipated that losing her election bid in controversial fashion to the Republican Brian Kemp would have catapulted her to the heights of the Democrat Party. In September, she still hadn't conceded. As this Yahoo News article quotes her as saying,
you've still not conceded, and you talk about it and you say that a missed defeat, and that's not what you're willing to do. Can you talk about what does defeat mean to you and why you're still not willing to concede?
So my issue is concession in the political space is an acknowledgement that the process was fair. And I don't believe that to be so.
That's good enough for the Democrats. It's good enough for their media. But now Trump is suddenly Hitler because he has legitimate legal challenges and this race isn't officially over. I'm really glad I took that week off because I'm feeling re-energized and I'm ready to take these people on. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this episode, please hit that like button, share, and subscribe. If you'd like to support this channel, you can find all those links in the description or pinned comment. Thanks for watching. Keep coming back.